Today, the TinySA Ultra arrived. Let's see what's inside this package. As you can see, nice small box with golden print and the text Tiny Spectrum Analyzer, and the Ultra is denoted here. Let's open the box and see what's inside. There's the plastic bag with inside the TinySA. Let's look how it looks. Let's remove the foil and put a TinySA next to it, so you have some comparison of the size. What is different? If you look to the outside of the box, you can see that the ports are denoted here in a different way. There's no longer a high and a low, but you have only one RF connector and you have the calibration connector. If you look to at the bottom, you see there's the USB port, but next to the USB port there's also an SD card slot and an audio headphone jacket. This is a standard 3.5 mm headphone jacket, and you can use either for a sensitive headphone or to connect it to a amplifier if needed. At the top side, everything is as we are used to. We have the on-off switch and the jog wheel. When we switch the device on, we can see the first big difference, and that is that the default maximum frequency is 800 MHz. The standard input range for the RF connector is between 0 and 800 MHz. So you no longer have to switch between high and low range, but you can go or monitor this complete range in one sweep. If you go to the menus, then we see the preset is very similar to what we previously had. Frequency is, there's a small difference, and that if you go to the RBW, or the resolution filter menu, you see that instead of 3 kHz being the smallest resolution filter, you now have also resolution filters of 1 kHz and 200 Hz, and there's one larger resolution filter, 850 kHz. In the level menu, there's also a new item, and that's the LNA. The LNA provides 20 dB of extra gain if you have very low level signals. But the measurements of the TinySA do not stop at 800 MHz. And this is due to its ultra mode. In the ultra mode, you can reach much higher frequencies. So let's first enable the ultra mode. We go to config, more, and we enable ultra. And it will tell you that you should visit a web page to get an unlock code. And the reason that we sent you to the web page is because there are some explanatory message on that web page that explains how the ultra mode works. And there are some limitations in the performance of the ultra mode, and it's important that you understand this. Otherwise, you can have measurements which makes no sense. So I'm going to enter the unlock code. And immediately the scan range changes, and now the TinySA scans up to 3 GHz, so from 0 to 3 GHz. But I can go even higher. I can set the stop frequency to 6 GHz. As you can imagine, the time for scanning increases. And here it is, over the full range up to 6 GHz, you see a jump here, and that's because the TinySA switches to another mode at 5.35 GHz, and where it has some less sensitivity, and that's reflected in the noise floor. For more information on the TinySA Ultra, visit tinysa.org. The link is in the description of the video.